Okay, welcome to Lunar Astro today. Today I have three people with me, Darshan Ji, who is one of my students. All three are my students, but Darshan Ji and Ritesh, they are in current batch. Darshan Ji was in first batch. The third person, he don't want to be renamed or filmed due to various reasons, and you will know why very soon, why you don't want camera. But today's topic, Prashna. Prashna is something which can give you instant answers for anything. And I tell you from where this notion started for Prashna, where the bug in me started for Prashna. A legendary astrologer sitting in a hospital in Delhi, in Apollo. And doctor is examining him. And he told the doctor, you know what, you do not have kids. And if you do one of my work, I will make sure you will have kids. And doctor looked sideways and says, and you know, how do you know that I don't have kids? I said, you know, I'm an astrologer, I know things. And I know that you require kids badly at this point in life. This is ruining your married life. I will tell you how you will get the kids. I will tell you the remedy of it. But the condition is, you bring me weed in hospital. I need to have it because he had habit. He's very old now. At that point in 90s, he was like late 70s or early 80s. Right now he's in 90s. And he said, I need to have that every day. If I don't have it, I get very cranky. Please get me. In terms, it is called as bhang. He said, bring me that 250 grams of it and I will tell you the remedy. And he told every single thing about the doctor. And doctor was in like, you know, in a very confused state of mind now. He's a neurologist, a neurosurgeon. He has never seen anything, experienced like anything like this before. So the relatives explained to doctor, he said, you know, whatever he says, he's doing only by astrology. He has no other powers, just astrology. And the doctor brought him that weed in the hospital. He had it. He said, okay, do this particular remedies, you will get a kid in this particular time period. And that happened. Now that incident, when I heard it, I was like, you know, there has to be a way without the charts. I thought he has some siddhi. And I asked him, I said, do you practice some kind of a siddhi? You know, because you used to do a lot of job and a very, very religious guy. He said, no, I just made the chart and that's why I predicted. He said, how can you make the charts without the, you know, just in the sky, without any degrees, without any navanch? He said, because you are stupid, you know, you're not using your brain. And you know, all the old time astrologers, they speak like this, they have used you a lot. And he said, you know, learn to make charts in your head. And he taught me a technique, a very simple technique, by using a Surya Siddhanta. Using the panchang, basically, as traditional panchang. Every morning you only need to know the position of moon, the degree of sun. Everything else will be in the same place. All you have to calculate is the ascendant degree in your head. And this is once you know your sunrise time at the place. Every morning when I wake up nowadays, I write down the sunrise time. So after that, you can make the charts throughout the day with the help, and you can go at this particular time. This is the ascendant rising with this particular degree. Rest of everything you can do. So this is what I kept doing over a period of time. But now it has reached to a level where I think, you know, it is getting better every day. It has amazed me to a point. I mean, I was stunned by the predictions. So I think the first I tried it on Darshanji. Darshanji called me up. And he said, business is, because he has a software company. So he said, you know, business is not coming in. And he said, you know what, because it's very hot here, the day it will rain in Delhi. Okay, see, this is a prediction I made for this. I said, the day it will rain in Delhi, you will get the money. Then after a few more days, like 2-3 weeks, he called me up again. He said, no, the money is really not coming in. The clients are coming and going, their inquiries, their everything. but they're not signing a deal. At that point, I made the impression. I said, you know, within 2 days, moon is going in Ashlesha, the deal will happen. This was the second prediction. Then Darshanji, what happened with you?
I'll give a little bit of history around this also.
Okay.
In one of the classes in the first batch, mm-hmm. you have basically taken the chart and you were basically demonstrating a technique. So you had basically said that in May, there'll be some, you know, the customer aayega, paisa aayega, aapka matlab jo hai. And then you also said that you'll use that money for some purpose. And then you gave the system all the way, said that okay, you can actually not only go to the month level, you go to the date level also to predict which dates, you know, the event will happen. So there were in all 3 dates. So 8th, 10th to 12th May, the second one was 23rd, 25th May, and third one was 30th May to 2nd June. So my birthday is 3rd September, so basically now exactly on those three, you know, those din ke jo basically jo hote hai, so those 2 days spans, people called up, and these are fat clients. Fat means fat, okay? Fat means FAT, fat. Okay, they called up on their own, and the event happened exactly on those days. And I was stunned that this technique is really working right to the day. So I checked my last 20 years of professional life in the sense, okay, when all and there was a very high correlation, except for I think twice. I mean, every important change or every important significant jump or event, I could see it was getting correlated. It wasn't happening at two other events, points, and there also I think I discussed with you what probably could have been the reason. There were some transits which were not let, I mean, the event happened, but then it got truncated very quickly. So now what happened was this, after that, I mean, the events had happened, but final fructification, we signed the papers and, you know, get on board, that wasn't happening. So that's when I was really getting, you know, jittery. So this was, I think, June first week when I think I was talking to you, look, the events have happened exactly on the date, but the paperwork hasn't happened. Then you said, okay, you just mentally ran the chart in your mind and said, and you said, aapko pata paisa kab aayega? I said, ab dekho, monsoon kab aa raha hai. I said, monsoon kab aa raha hai? What does it have to do with monsoon? I thought you were joking, but you were serious. Probably you were testing out some technique or doing something. I don't know what you were doing. So then you said, monsoon kab aa raha hai? Jab Delhi mein barish hoga na, theek hai na, tab aapko paisa milega. I was like, you're pulling my leg or something. You're just, you know, you're not in the mood or something. So that's how it looked like at that moment. So then probably after another 2-3 weeks down the line, I thought, I mean, probably I should ask you this question once again. So then you said, nahi aayega. Abhi wo monsoon dekho kab aayega. Then I actually sat down and saw the charts. I said, okay, Kerala mein June first week mein aaya. Ye to July ke mid mein aayega. So 1.5 mahine aur wait karna padega. I said, okay. Then I forgot about it. Finally, I think July 1st or 2nd week, probably it was a week, I think last to last Wednesday probably. When I actually asked you that now you have to look real, I mean, seriously you have to look into this, because how come the event is not fructifying? Okay, I mean, it's happened on the those dates, initiation has happened, fructification is not happening, final paper they sign over. At that moment, I think I was very serious. I thought it was very, you know, emotionally charged. So you said, okay, what is the Prashna? So you created the Prashna in your mind and you said, okay, wait for 2-3 days. It won't happen today. It will happen in 2-3 days. Just wait for 2-3 days. So because I was asking you that if this doesn't happen, I'm looking at some alternate action. So last Friday, 11 o'clock, I was sitting in the car. I was talking to the clients. So you said that moon, when it enters Ashlesha Nakshatra, so you made the prediction Wednesday. Friday is when it entered. I think Thursday evening or Friday it entered Ashlesha Nakshatra. That's exactly when it happened. Two clients came on board within that 1 hour and it was raining. Thursday evening was drizzling and Friday it was pouring, raining. I was sitting inside and it was raining. I said, okay, this is the prediction you made. So Saturday I sent you the snapshot that this is the prediction you had made. And this is how it happened on Friday. And after that, probably, you know, it is still raining. Yes. What's happened is there are more clients coming. So I don't know what's going on. So
see, that's the magic of astrovastu as well, astrocartography as well. If you start living in, like today I told you, if you go and start living in any place where it rains frequently, the money, if and the money will come to you.
Okay.
If you go and decide, you know, you want to live in a Gurgaon, which is a dry city, or Noida, where it's mostly dry. Now it's a much better place because Noida, it's a swampland basically, the Greater Noida. If you live there, you have a combination, you'll get the money. Keep getting the money. If you move to Cherrapunji, you get a lot of money over there because it rains almost every day. Live near the beach, the money will come. Water has a significant, very significant event to play in your chart with the money.
Right.
Like, it looks a bit crazy, but that's how the tattva work. That has a tattva element of the chart works. Like one of your friends, you remember, I told him to move this particular machinery from this particular place and throw it out.
Yeah.
And that guy didn't follow it till until and unless you reminded him. Because I told him that, Ritesh, he was discussing me that this particular person is going to give me the projects. I said, he is, until unless he removes that machinery, nothing is working for him. The moment he removed that machinery, I think, what was that machinery, Darshanji?
It was an old communication device. So basically, Purana telephone bada hua tha. It was dead. It was still sitting there as a... some kind of, you know, just log rakh lete na ki hai dekho khubsurat rakh lo, but it's dead, it's not working, it's gathering dust. So you said remove that and you're done reading for him, and you said there's a electronic device, communication device, sitting in a certain part of the house, please go and remove that. So for 2 to 3 months after this prediction session with you, he did not remove it. Then suddenly, you know, when I mentally went with him, okay, what all did he predict? And he said, acha ye bola tha, ye bola tha, ye bola tha. I said, acha ye device isko hatao yaar. So Friday we discussed. Sunday he removed it, I think around 2 o'clock. 4:30 to 5, an old client came and called back. For 2 months he wasn't obliging. Even 3 hours he called him. And he actually told his wife, saying, yaar ye bola tha usme ki aisa karne pe hoga, so ye ho raha hai. And his wife said, it's all nonsense, aisa kuch nahi hota. Then after that, he, I think, did one or two other remedies also, and they have worked. So
you see, it can be fluke once. It cannot be fluke every single time. Vastu cannot be fluke every single time. If you are going with the, if I'm not even visited your house and I'm telling you there's a communication device old sitting there blocking your money, remove it. It has an evidence worked every single time. Like with the other guy who do not want to be named, PC. He called me up and you know, he said, you know, I'm not getting married. From last 5 years I'm trying, every time I get married. About to get married, something happens, marriage do not take place. I told him, you know what, 3 days you are getting married. And he said, sir, it's not possible, you're not listening to me. And I said, no Prashant, you know what, 3 days I will call you back, I will call you after 3 days. This is what I told him, because there's no point to argue once you make the prediction. He told me several reasons not to get married. He said, 3 days, we'll talk about it. Right, PC?
Right, sir.
So, what happened in 3 days? Did you get married?
Yes, sir. Exactly the third day.
So, sir,
it was my first experience with Prashna. I am learning astrology since last 1 year, but never deal with Prashna. And this is the most wonderful experience of my life, sir. After 7 years of relationship, I'm not getting married. Whenever I asked my girlfriend to get married, she always delayed it. She said, my parents are not allowing me. So please wait for some time. And I was just like, ki shayad kumara hi marunga. So 8th July, maine sir ko call kiya, ki, sir, will my marriage happen? Or if yes, then after how many days? And you replied, after 20 or 30 seconds of calculation, and you replied, Prashant, your marriage is going to happen after 3 days. I was like, no sir, it's impossible. Nahi ho sakta ye. And you said, no, no argument. I will call you after 3 days. When moon will enter in Chitra Nakshatra, the event will get fixed. And after 3 days, you will get married. 8th July, 12:28 p.m. This is the time. 10th July, evening, it's 6 p.m. Sir called me, you called me, and said, Prashant, India haar gayi. I said, sir, yes. Teri shaadi fix ho gayi. I said, sir, yes.
Sir.
Kyunki, uske aapke call ke, before 2 hours, when I talk to you, 2 hours, my girlfriend called me and said, let's get married. I have done all preparations. We will go to this temple and we will get married. After that, we will talk to our parents. Right. So I said, yes, okay. 11th July, I call you and said, sir, mere phere ho chuke hain.
Sir, moon moved into Chitra and that person, 28 degree Virgo was rising. Saturn came to 4th house. Saturn was aspecting Lagna, so girl is bigger in age. Ketu,
yes.
It's a hidden marriage. That's how the Prashna worked. Moon will enter into Chitra Nakshatra, the event will happen. There is no argument. When the chart says that it is going to happen, it will happen. In any case, like, I'll tell you another example now, Ritesh. Ritesh, my friend, a very emotional person because cancer is changing. He works, he deals in business on based on emotions. He trusts people easily. And he called me up in a very tense situation. He said, I have loaned $500,000 to someone on my name. I'm not getting any response. Please tell me if I'm going to get the money or not. So it was just before the lunar eclipse. I made the chart twice for him in the for the Prashna. And the answer was that do not look at the chart at this particular time period. The answer is going to be wrong. So I left it. After the lunar eclipse got over, I looked into the chart in the morning and then I replied in 1 line to the Ritesh. Ritesh, the day moon will enter into Shravan or Dhanishta, you will get a way out of your problem. Do not worry. It is the help is on the way. And Ritesh, it happened.
Yes, sir. Happened. Same exact day. As soon as moon entered Shravan, I got a surprising text message. Every time I call him, he's like, I'll let you know Monday. I'll let you know Friday. And people are calling me about the money. Before I messaged you, I actually called my bank and I'm like, hey, I've got this property. I need to borrow $500,000. I promised somebody I'm going to pay it back. And then I'm like, let me just text you like before I move forward with the bank stuff. Because once I give somebody my word that if he doesn't pay, I'll pay, then I'm like, now it's my responsibility to pay him back. And so before I did that, I texted you about my situation and you didn't reply for the day. And that really got me worried. I'm like, what's going on? How could I sleep that night? and then when I saw your reply in the morning, I was so happy. Like, it was the best day I've had in so many, you know, months. And at approximately when moon was entering the Shravan, he texted me, hey, I've got a good news for you. Like, can we talk? I was like, yes, we can talk. And he called me up in 30 minutes. We talk and says, hey, I've got the money. My money that was stuck from past 4 or 5 months, it's getting released. It's hitting my account on the 5th of September. On the 6th, you can deposit my check.
Okay.
And right. Done.
See, Prashna, but I'm telling you one thing. Even if the Prashna is like this, all the techniques of Prashna is something which you have learned in the basic course. How does the Aries will behave? How does the different planets? Because when you know the energy of the sign, when you know the energy of the planet, you use that in your personal techniques. See how they're behaving. How different planets Like yesterday, remember Darshan Ji sent you a message regarding the Venus in us. That particular person was asking, right? Something that I have a problem, this problem, this problem, this problem. I replied him in one line. The father has done something wrong with the woman in this particular month. Please ask him. This is the backfire of it. There's no remedy. So the Prashna picks up every single thing. The only thing is you have to need to see in the chart. But that example which I'm giving you is from a natural chart. Venus was an oscillation nakshatra. So right now we are learning the sign. If you know the energy of the sign, you take it up, mix it with the planet, see how it is going to behave, make a prediction, and do not back off. Like if the Prashant says, "I'm not going to get married from next 3 days," do not get worried. Your Prashna is telling you now that he's getting married in 3 days. It is 3 days. It cannot be the fourth day. It cannot be the second day. Similarly. We all know the planet which is governed by water is Venus, Moon, sign of Cancer, sign of which kind of water is Cancer, you know. Now at this present, you know the Cancer water will be different from the Scorpio water, will be different from the Pisces water. There's another watery sign, Aquarius. All three, four waters are different. They have a different meaning. They have a different all set together. So for Darshan, only when it will rain, the rain water will help him. The beach water will give him some kind of relief, but only the rain water. Darshan, if I remember, when you the things you were telling me regarding the Texas or was Vegas, like he used to live in Vegas and he was going through a lot of problems. Vegas is a dry land. And the moment he moved from Vegas to Tampa, near the beach, problems start getting resolved. Now tell me the Vedic astrocartography does not work. It is based on his chart that whenever he will go to a dry land, if you want to get really dry in life, go to a dry land, things will go bad for you.
Maybe I need to install a shower on top of my, you know. Off a seat or something. Anyway, joke apart. But yeah, it works. It works.
So that's how the magic of Prashna is. That's how all the credit of this Prashna goes to the basics. When we know the basics of sign, when we know the basics of nakshatras, to a level you can feel like every class we will do. There is an event which happens to that particular sign because we activate the energy of that sign. So if we know the energy of sign, this is going to happen. So that's the magic of Prashna.
I have a question. Yes. So like in PC's case, you were saying that Gemini ascendant, Ketu in the Raja and Saturn in fourth house.
No, Virgo ascendant.
Virgo ascendant.
Ketu was in the Lagna. Or Ketu happened in the fourth house.
Yeah.
Okay. So that means it's an old relationship because Saturn is aspecting the Lagna. Now, typically you would say that Lagna is the... If you pick up most of the Prashna books, Lagna is the querent. Okay. And then you basically look at the houses.
Seventh house.
Respect to that. Okay. But you made the prediction that since Saturn is aspecting the Lagna, so the person about whom the question is being asked, so the spouse in this case, he's elder. So, why not the seventh house? Why the first house?
Okay. Whenever the question involves I, when will I get married? It will always from the Lagna.
Okay.
When if you ask me when this particular person will get married, I will go to the seventh house.
Okay.
Like whenever you ask, when will I buy the house? I will go to the Lagna and make the prediction. But if you say, when this particular person will buy the house or any other question regarding the house, if there is a missing I in it, I will not. That's the key for using the question. And if you make the chart of 12/28 on that particular day, on 8th of July, that particular day, you will find it was not 28 degrees Virgo. It was the Panchang, which I'm using. That is giving me the 28 degrees Virgo. It might be the Libra in the other softwares. So the Prashna, I don't use softwares, I use Panchang.
It is very coincidental because when you made the Prashna for me, it was also 28 degrees Virgo.
Is it?
Yes.
Now, because it might be the time period of between 11 to 12 or 11 to 1. That time the Virgo rises. Now from today onwards, because the sun has moved to Cancer, so the ascendant will rise with the Cancer.
Maybe that's the time nature sends people in dire straits to you.
Because you're asking about the sixth house matters. No? Yes, you're asking about your problems. You're asking about when I will get the job. Like for Ritesh also, when I made the Prashna, I don't remember the love now, but Saturn was very prominent. That's why I did not told him that you are going to get the money. I said, you'll get a way out of it. The money, the second house was not getting involved in fructifying the results. The money was not coming to him. But the help was on the way. So that's why I told him, you know, you'll get the way out of it, but not the money right now. It will take some time. Because Saturn was very strongly aspecting the ascendant nakshatra lord, the moon nakshatra lord, the ascendant lord as well. So it was expecting all the three things at the same time. So, you know, has to wait. But definitely you will get the money. So my honest advice is for the Prashna, read the signs, read the Tattva. Once you master this regarding, especially regarding the Tattva and the Vastu. Tattva, if you know the Tattva, you can master the Vastu. And in this particular chart, this particular tattva is harming him. Like today, this was a doctor, he's a surgeon. And I looked in his chart, almost same combination as you, Darshanji. And I said, since it started raining, because he was going through, I can see in the chart, he was going through the divorce problems. There was a lot of 8th lord, because wife's family, 8th lord and 10th lord connections, wife's family is going to harm him, 8th and 9th lord connections. And all the divisional charts. So I said, you know, you're going through the disputes through the wife. But since the rain has started, you should have come to an agreement, mutual agreement. You should have made peace. Because moon is a fourth house, peace. You make peace with people. That you should have made peace with the in-laws. I said, yes. The day the monsoon started, it has already happened. The only one case is left from their end. They're about to take it back. The settlement is going on. And I said, do it before the rain overs. Because once the rain is over, you will not be able to go through that same peace and same kind of a mutual agreement anymore. Because moon gives the mutual agreement.
Yes. Back, something similar had happened. We just discussed, I think, 2 hours back. Very similar. That result came in a very similar way because a similar position that I also have.
Yes, so you also went through the mutual agreement during the when you moved to the new place where it rains.
So I was basically I was in Tampa, Florida at that time, and that's when you know it's almost the beach. So that's when basically the agreement happened.
So see, now you know that if you know this thing in your chart now. Now the money will rain. For some people, it has to be the hot places, summer climates. Okay. For some people, it has to be the Jupiter in city, where there are a lot of educational institutions, because they have a Jupiter strong. If they move to that particular place, they will get rich. So the tattva of the planets, and I did a video before on Vedic astrocartography. It's available. And if you practice it, you will find it works. 110% works. Only thing is you need to believe in it. So I hope you guys find a problem, a solution to your problem through Prashna.
Sir.
Yes.
A few days back, I was having a small get together in my house and my friend came in. He came into my office where I'm sitting here and I was reading this book.
Okay. Casey Saxena, sir.
And he's like, kya pad raha hai tu yaar, ye sab, you know, ye sab pagal bandi hai, ye sab padha, sab time waste mat kar apna, just, you know, read something else. Okay. Read some business book or this and that. Maine bola, theek hai, maine bola, chal ek kaam kar, give me your date of birth, give me your time of birth and a place, and I'll tell you three things, and that's it. He's like, agar tune mere ko de diya to main tereko pura saal main tereko party dunga.
Okay.
So I made his chart, Sagittarius ascendant. Maine usko bola ke sabse pehle you have a big problem in your bedroom life. You're not able to perform. Dusri baat, your dad, your whole family has broken their legs at some point in their life. Third point, you did not get married until you cried in front of your wife. And I shut the chart up and I went away. He called me. He's like, how the hell did you tell me all this? He calls me every day, wants me to read his son's chart, wants to read his wife's chart, and I was like, no buddy, I'm not in the business of predicting or giving consultations. I'm just learning for my own sake, and that's it.
Yes, see the combinations now, where you have to cry. We did a video on it, like, yes, wherever the moon
was. That's how I made the prediction. I saw that, I was like, damn, like this was bang on. He has problems and he was crying that I love you so much, why are you doing this to me? And then I finally got married because of that. Usne bola ke nobody knows this.
Yeah, see that's what I want with every one of my students now. If I'm giving you a technique, now I've tested it 110 times on charts because I do it every single day. If I'm telling you now that works, it works. If it doesn't work, it doesn't work. I throw it out. You have to narrow it down things. You have to make three predictions. The three predictions which you made. I'm telling you, if you book a consultation with some of really big astrologers, they will not be able to make it. And just for the viewers, I'm asking you, have you any astrology experience before this class?
Sir, I was just reading, watching videos, reading book here and there. But I knew the basics here and there, but I was never able to predict, not a single thing. I would just look at a chart and just be like, stare at it.
But you know that what the course has done. Till now we've done how many classes? Nine classes we have done?
Nine classes. I cannot wait for that.
So that's why you're going to only predict on the nine signs, right? You can make 15, 20 predictions easily, right?
Yeah.
So you see, this is the level I want. You look at the Shukra-Vanji combination and say, everyone in your family has broken the legs. It's there. And you see, I've given out three lineages right now. I've given out Shukra-Vanji, Surya-Vanji, Chandra-Vanji. I have stopped the other four. I've kept it the other four as a backup right now. Because I had the intuition for some reason in my dream, I had like, I should not give it out. I should not give it out. And somebody was telling me, you should stop now. You should not give out these techniques now. And I see, and I saw a lot of forums, a lot of YouTube channels, they started copying it. They kind of modified it and tried to push. And I said, okay, you know, it's fine. You can do it. And they're charging money for this, you know, they're charging that this is the combination which is karmic and this is super karmic or pending karma. This is not the pending karma. Pending karma is something entirely different. I've shown you guys several times that were prediction. Like Darshanji, I'm telling you about dreams. One day I called Darshanji and I asked him one question. And I said, how are you doing any meditation or any kind of puja in your home? And he had always had a confusion whether he should use true notes or mean notes. And I called him up. I said, you know, you should use mean notes. Your Rahu is in Dhanishta Nakshatra. And I said, how do you know? I said, because somebody told me in my dreams that tell him he need to do the puja. He has a Rahu in Dhanishta Nakshatra. Tell him to stop whining about the musical instruments he has brought. This is for a very good reason.
Amen. How would you know Rahu's intonation nakshatra in a subdivisional chart? And that made me crazy. How do you know? How are you telling these things?
And tell me, were you doing any kind of puja during those days when I called you?
So you made a prediction again in April, May. Aapka ghar badalne wala hai. Okay. Then something happened because of which I had to change my house. I'm sitting in a new house. So you see those blue bags over there? It's basically stuff which I'm still unpacking.
Okay.
So it's been 2 weeks. I think at that time it was 8 or 9 days when basically it had stopped. So 3-4 days when I was unpacking, and 2 weeks when I was packing stuff in the old house and unpacking here. Puja, everything was stopped. And that's when you called and you told me these two things. That someone came in the dream and told me this. You have Rahu in the rest, that's why you bought these instruments. I was like, when I was setting up my room, I was setting my studio, and I composed tracks and all also. And I was sitting there, sitting idly. I was going to do the wiring again. I go and get depression. So that is one room which is still left. The wiring remains. And then he said, no, you are doing this because there is a specific karma. And for you to say Rahu and Dhanishta, okay, I was like, this is some other force talking. I said, okay, just fold your hands, obey what is being said to you, and just go and get that room fixed.
Yeah, you see, sometimes you get the answers in dreams, and sometimes for you people, when I have to deliver something or not to deliver something, you'll get a very strong message. Like, Nimitz will work. Like, you might be abusing your musical instruments for some reason. Maybe, I don't know. And I had a dream that you need to tell him to stop abusing the musical instruments he has brought. This is for a very particular reason he has brought it. Tell him to stop abusing and start praying. His Rahu is in Dhanishta. And I was like, why this dream has came to me? Okay, let me call him and ask him what is happening. So that's how, the dream worked. Every time the dream works, before anything good or bad will happen. If you have a good amount of
That actually calmed me down a lot, in the sense, many times you do some kind of meditation, something, and nothing's happening. It's like you're just hallucinating. But then when this kind of an event happens, you realize, no, there is a power somewhere is watching you.
Yeah.
It exists. So stop getting frustrated or stop getting angry. Someone's listening.
Yeah, see, that's what the Jyotish is. Now, Jyotish should bring a lot of peace to your life. Like the Jupiter does, when I taught you Jupiter. If a Jyotish is not bringing peace in your life, if it's not bringing the true happiness in your life, you're missing something. You're not doing it right. So, that's my advice for the day, for the Prashna. Instead of book, concentrate on the tattva, concentrate on the science, concentrate on the science. Like, people were asking me, what are you going to teach in world classes, science, A book of 300 rupees has the science. But I had no answers to it, what I'm going to teach and how I'm going to write it down. But you see where the course is now. So I hope you guys learn something new.
Yes,
coming.
Yes, sir.
And I'll see you next time. Thank you for coming.
Thank you.